Ladies and gentlemen, we are back.
How do you do?
How do I do?
Yes.
Well.
With a heart attack?
With a heart attack. It's still here.
Still there.
Surprisingly enough.
And we have another exciting match here.
Matches.
Champ versus champ. It's Fish versus Sensei.
Yes, Fish, the winner of our last tournament. And Sensei, the winner of the tournament before that one.
Yes.
So Zero Suit Samus versus Zero. What are you doing?
Butt check.
Oh, it's a button check. Okay, cool. I thought they already started. I was about to say, I'm like, why? What are you doing, Fish?
What have you done? I'm hoping to see another Donkey Kong in this tournament.
I am.
Someone's trying to prove us wrong.
Somebody is trying to prove me mainly, because I'm the one
mainly,
that...
You're the one that talked crap about Donkey Kong.
I pooped on Donkey Kong. He is. He got flays.
He got flays.
No, not me. Kong.
Okay. Donkey Kong.
Yes. And funny enough, let's sidetrack for just a moment on Donkey Kong.
All right.
Nobody really uses Diddy.
Diddy? That's right.
And Diddy Kong is a really good character.
Yeah.
The last 5-6 tournaments, I haven't seen a Diddy Kong.
So
sad. I hate Diddy Kong.
I mean, last tournament you got Heal Life with Ike.
With Ike.
You didn't see, well, except for Pio. Use Ike.
Yeah, exactly.
She just killed him with Ike.
Yeah, but I don't think she's here today,
no,
unfortunately.
She's not here today. She's somewhere.
Out there.
Oh, Heal Life. Anyway.
Now you're scaring me. What's in that tea?
Green tea. Pomegranate.
Pomegranate. Yeah, but going back on that, I mean, just elaborating, I want to elaborate, Diddy Kong to me is an annoying character. It's not that if somebody picks him, I'm going to hate on him. I just think he's super annoying. Anyways.
Serious hoo-ha.
Yeah, no, I mean, that's the combination that, I mean, they patched it, it doesn't do what it used to, but it's still so annoying. But again, moving forward on that, Diddy Kong, definitely a pretty darn competitive, good competitive character. But we do see a lot of the top tier ends over here. We've seen Rosalina, we're seeing Zero Suit Samus and Mario. People do pick a lot of the top tiers. And again, I would be very surprised, and actually, you know, truth be told, pretty pleased to see a Donkey Kong place.
Very, very, yeah, it was very.
Because it's going to be a very high level of skill, a very good player that can make something like that happen.
It's very refreshing to see.
Yeah, but in the meantime, I'm going to poop on the Kong.
Yeah, Donkey Kong's poop.
Poop.
Stick with eating bananas and flea-ridden monkey staying in the jungle.
And the sure.
Sure. Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Why not? But, you know, Rosalina, I've noticed it's always, most of the time, it's used near the end of the tournament.
Yeah, I mean, Rosalina, not a very popular character, though she is pretty top tier, though she does have a lot of advantages. A lot of people just don't play as her.
Yeah.
Seems to be kind of like that rule, like, okay, are you going to pick her, really?
Yeah.
You know? So, we shall see. And Fish said he was inspired by Nairo. And
Nairo.
So definitely does, and you know, he's a very talented player, very good, one of the best around
in the world.
And his Zero Suit is pretty fantastic. So we're gonna see the up air.
Oh my goodness, this is a really good matchup.
So far, yeah. I mean, definitely no player. Neither of these two players are giving an inch. They're both gonna go, and they're gonna hit for the outfield in this. Oh, they're going to go for it. It's going to be very interesting, and it's really a toss-up between the both of them, but I must get your predictions before the end.
Right,
who's going to take it? Come on, Vaughn. Who's going to take it? I'm going to put you in that spot. Who's going to take it?
I'm going to go with my boy Fish.
You're going to go with your boy Fish? Well, I'm going to play devil's advocate, and I'm going to take Sensei.
Okay, take him.
All right, so you got Fish. I'm going to take Sensei, and let's see what's happening here. Ooh, projectile versus projectile. Neither of the competitor getting the advantage from that exchange.
Nice.
And Fish takes it with that forward air.
Back to even Steven again.
Yeah, basically. And let's see, it's going to be balance versus agility and speed on this one. Seeing if Sensei is going to take advantage of those neutrals. Ooh, and here we go. Six. Ooh, you almost got six hits off that combo. And again, it's even at this point. Ooh. Oh, wow. That recovery was immediate. Awesome job. Oh, man. He's going for that down smash. He was real quick about it. Ooh, going for that grab. He's being extremely aggressive. Good job there. Ooh, okay. Up. Ooh, oh.
Knows when to dodge there.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's a very effective combo, but you have to get the follow-up on that almost immediately.
You don't want to fall into that combo.
No, you don't want to, but in order to take advantage of it, the Zero Suit player has to have immediate access to the opponent. If there's even too much of a second, you know, if there's like a second or more delay, if it's a highly skilled opponent, they're going to dodge it each and every time. And that's going to be the issue. A lot of tricky timing with Mario. And honestly speaking, just blazingly fast speed with Zero Suit Samus. Ooh, wow.
Is it going to be the air combo?
I mean, took that throw right off of Sensei's recovery. Ooh, here we go with the battle exchange there. And it probably does befit... Gonna say that probably Zero Suit is gonna take the advantage whenever they have an exchange of projectiles. Ooh. Since hers paralyzes.
Right.
Oh, is he gonna take? Ooh. Yeah. I'm noticing he's not being very aggressive with the flip kick. Probably wants to stay away from an up smash counter.
Yeah.
Oop, and there he goes. A lot of fast falls, gonna probably be a little bit necessary here. Keep in mind that her forward air is very, very effective because of multiple hits. Does have a little bit of lag on the recovery and on the way back down. Mario can pretty much close the gap pretty darn quickly.
See, those kicks are dangerous.
They are. They definitely are. And he is up in that blast zone. He's basically trying to go ahead and bait him, see if he can get the setup going here. He's going to go for that throw as quickly as he can. So basically fireball, fireball. If he can get the upspin.
And if he tries to go in the air, then try to get him in the air.
Yeah, he's going to try to get him with the upspin. He does not. I mean, Fish definitely doesn't want something like that to happen. He's going to probably throw on whiff, and he's going to try to go ahead and close the gap with either that forward kick or the tilt, or the forward tilt, or he's going to try to go ahead and just create that wall with a neutral A combo. But I haven't seen him do that just yet. Nope, there we go. See, on the whiff, and there he goes. He did get one. Ooh, and he gets that forward air.
Wow.
And Sensei's out. They're down one stock. Damage is negligible on Fish's part because at 30%, it's anybody's game at this point. Ooh, went right through him. Well, what was up with that? I was thinking he was going to go for a reverse throw. Oh, he got one up air.
Sensei's really good at trying to break that combo.
Him picking Mario basically consistently is making a statement. And that statement is, I'm ready. You know, bring your best. And is he going to get a second? Oh! Going for that setup. If he gets that up B after even just one flip kick, it can be dire. Especially if he gets him from the platform.
Potentially bring out somebody with this combo.
Oh, absolutely. Oh, and is he going to get... Nope. Did not. Kept the shield at the last second. Ooh. Not seeing any shield shuffling so far today. Or maybe I just haven't been paying attention. But then again, a lot of our competitors just like to get right in there. Don't mind getting their hands dirty.
Very effective technique.
Ooh, just a straight stand up, and he got the throw. Ooh, how's that recovery? Ooh, he's going to pay for that recovery. Yes, he is. Ooh. And Sensei takes that first round. Good job, guys.
It is. Very good round.
Very good. Yeah, come on.
I'm going ahead of myself.
I'm so excited. I want it to end. No. Let's keep it going, gents. No, they're going to stick with the same competitors. I don't think the Fish is going to be peeking Pikachu. I don't think he's going to do it. And let's see what the counter pick is going to be. Okay, same stage. No. Yeah, they're going to stick with that. Now, to Fish's advantage, is going to go ahead and see if he can keep Sensei long enough on any of those platforms, land that up A, and then go into an up B and get him into that blast zone immediately. As it stands, the longer you leave Sensei in the stage, the longer you leave any really good Mario character on the stage, the more dire it is for you.
Yeah, I noticed something. That's a very smart stage that Fish plays.
Yeah, absolutely. It plays to Zero's strengths.
Right.
the last thing that Zero really wants, since she's such an agile character, an open stage, though she can rock it, it's not really to her benefit.
The last round, Sensei keep throwing the fireballs at her.
Yeah.
So those platforms can help. It could burn.
I mean, definitely Pikmin is going to be... I said that mistakenly earlier that they had Battleground last time. It was the Animal Crossing stage that they were on previously. So a little bit more open of an area, and you can see what I'm talking about right there. You know, leaves a lot for Mario to go ahead and take advantage, because with Zero's suit, her paralyzer, at least the standard blast, is always going to travel the same way. Whereas Mario has a lot of shifts and changes in his fireball. So you definitely have to be used to it and see... There we go. And it's actually Sensei, the one that's taking advantage of these platforms and getting fish off into the sunset. You know, he thinks this is a Western. It's not a Western. It's Smash Brothers. Will he get it? Yep, he's in. Fantastic stage defense and ready for the recovery. He's ready for scenario A, B, and C, no matter what it might be for the opponent to get in.
Got in the edge.
Exactly. Again, a good stage defense is never just going to rely on one move to keep the opponent from coming in. That stage defense, 9 times out of 10, it's planning for the opponent to get through it. It's what the follow-up is going to be after that, depending on how the opponent gets back in. And as we can see here, Fish is definitely trying for that setup. He wants to get those up airs and go into that straight up B. You know, again, Zero Suit Samus's reach on her throw is fantastic. It's that recovery that's a serious problem. And, you know, again, Sensei does have to get close to get the throw off, but once he's there, it's quick animation, quick recovery. It's in and out. Boom! And there we go. See what I'm talking about? Ooh, and he's going for his own up A. Ooh, went to the spare change. Did he get it? Now, here's a funny thing about the spare change. It's one of the weaker moves in the game. Does not actually do... At a lot of instances, does not actually do one damage. You are aware of that.
Yeah.
With Smash, there are moves that do less than one. They do 0.5 damage. What Smash does is it levels it off to zero.
Yeah.
But if the spare change hits just right at the right height on the blast zone, you could be ring out at zero damage. Look it up on YouTube.
Really?
Yes. You will be pleasantly surprised once your jaw gets back into place. But basically, it's a pretty safe bet. Damage isn't always going to be the deciding factor. It's how far up you can get your opponent. That's why combos are so essential. And definitely Zero Suit and Mario are two pretty combo-licious characters.
Combo-licious.
Boom! Speaking of which, there it goes. Looks like Fish is just going to go forego.
I mean, Fish has
got to
keep up with this one.
Yep. Ooh, and he got the throw.
Huge chunk of damage on him.
Exactly. Nice.
Oh.
Is he going to get it? Nope. I'm pretty much going to be surprised if he can get a third up air on Sensei at this point. Sensei, wow, so distracting. Fireball, fireball, fireball. I'm going to come in and close the gap. You either...
You got grab, or if you jump, we'll do spinny thingy on you.
Yes, the spinny thingy. We're going to call it the mini Zangief clothesline. But yeah, I mean, basically the upspin is definitely a problem for a lot of characters. Simply, probably a character with an equally devastating downwards attack like that would be Yoshi when he does his down A and he starts running on your head. But Mario and Luigi compound this issue by actually exploding at the last hit and sending you flying upwards. And Mario definitely has a lot to take advantage of once he pops you up in the air. It's craziness. So, and it's funny, you know, Sensei works the whole screen. The stage is his. To him, he's like a pit bull in that sense. It's like a Rottweiler. The stage is mine. And
basically,
yeah. And a small stage, again, working to his advantage because he can get from point A to point B pretty quickly. Not as fast as Zero Suit, but, you know, still not anything you should, you know, take for granted. And boom, there he goes with the up B, missed it. The recovery, you know, hit him and Sensei took advantage of it. Again, Fish, a top-notch player. He was able to go ahead and, you know, keep the match going. Ooh, is he going to get it? Yes! Okay, they are at 1-1, but keep in mind, Fish is at 100% damage. He's going to have pretty soon he's going to get close to the damage advantage and start doing a little bit more damage himself. So, you know, pardoning me repeating myself. But really... yeah, you know. Damage amplification. He is steaming mad.
You don't want to be near.
Well, unless you're Sensei. Uh-oh, and that recovery, is he going to have to pay for it? And he is making it, he is narrowing the window down of where fish can land. He wants to put himself in the most optimal position where he can strike him. Ooh, got a paralyzer. And he's recovering. And he's rolling around. Oh, and he gets the up smash. Ladies and gentlemen, Sensei takes it 2-1. Excellent job, guys. Fantastic match.
All right, so Fish, former champ, going to the underdog bracket.
We got a lot of people in the underdog bracket. We got Deadpool in the underdog bracket. Let me check with Jovi. Is Deadpool still in circuit? All right, we will be back. Ladies and gentlemen,
don't go away.
Don't!
All right, hey everybody, this is Bon.
And I'm Manny.
And, Wait, Manny, you're a little bit ghostly than usual. Wait a minute. I know who you are. You're Jonathan again. Hey, yeah.
Figured me out. I am standing in for Manny till he gets back from whatever it is he's doing. Which
Manny's busy with the meal. Right now.
I think he's getting some tea.
Yes. Or tea?
Tea.
He's probably hoping for the best. I'm gonna have some tea from Chibi Boba.
Or maybe he is getting coffee.
Maybe
he's getting some cake. I don't know. I don't know what he's doing. All I know is I don't know what's going on here. Vaughn, can you explain to me what's going on here? I see two little kids fighting.
We got some kids fighting here.
Why are the children fighting?
They're supposed to fight the neighborhood, but in space? Really?
So what do we have here? This is Ness. I know Ness.
Yeah, we got Ness versus the villager. Not the one from the 70s or 80s, but
You mean the village people?
Yeah, the village
YMCA. Yeah. No, it's not them. They were all very gay.
Yes.
They're pretty gay. Okay. But anyways, yes, I don't think this villager is.
Yeah, it's not is, that. One.
Is that?
It's a kid. Villager is a kid.
Oh my.
Yes. So.
Totally not gay villager.
No, not the gay villager.
Okay.
But he's got potted plants.
Oh my.
He's got a hobby.
So, what game is Villager from? I'm not too familiar with it.
Animal Crossing.
Animal Crossing. Oh.
Animal Crossing.
That sounds very similar.
Yes. Started off in the GameCube.
Okay, I see.
Oh, we got the tree.
Oh, he's got a baseball bat. Go, Ness, go! I know Ness from Earthbound.
Yeah,
that's it.
Ness from Earthbound.
Yes.
Starting from the very first Super Smash Brothers. I didn't know who Ness was until I played the first Super Smash Brothers.
Shame on you, Vaughn. Yeah, Earthbound is a timeless classic. Yes. I played that game when it first came out. It was very good.
Oh, yes.
I remember I actually got a copy of Earthbound. Surprisingly how much it's worth now, but I actually got a copy of Earthbound for $10.
Please tell me you still have the game.
I do not.
Oh, my goodness.
I got it for $10
you would have
in
been
the big box.
By now.
Yeah, right? No.
Oh, my goodness.
But, yeah, I got it in the big box for $10. Brand new from Best Buy when Best Buy was having a clearance sale on them.
Wow.
Yeah. So, yep,
that's
just imagine
deep,
that.
Man.
If I knew then what I know now, I would have bought all the ones that they had right there.
Yeah. Oh, well. Lesson learned.
Exactly. You live and learn. So now I know that for the future, I have to create a time machine, make sure that I go back.
Whenever that opportunity arises.
Yes. Indeed.
Get a time machine.
So,
and I think Pio is going to make that time machine. He hasn't done it yet, so.
Hopefully.
I demanded him to do that.
We can only hope it.
Yeah. But tell me, Ranger Stop is when?
Ranger Stop is November 13th through the 15th. It's going to be at the Doubletree Hotel by Universal Studios Orlando.
Literally right across Universal Studios.
Yes. Literally right across
Universal Studios. You're having fun in Universal. Don't go. Go across the street and go to Doubletree.
Yeah. Go there instead. You'll have more fun there.
13th through 15th. 3-day events.
Yes. And that is where the finals, I guess, for this tournament are going to be held.
Right. It's going to be very intense finals in Ranger Stop.
Yeah.
But if... I think
they're all going to be to the death.
Yes.
I'm not mistaken.
Like Battle Royale.
Like the person that loses will die.
Yeah.
Literally.
And the other guy will get some coffee or something like that.
He'll get a coffee and he'll, you know, yes.
Yeah. So, but no cream, by the way, because this is an intense battle.
No cream, no sugar.
Yeah. Oh, tournament's intense. Okay. Ooh, okay. Was that Maverick? Maverick. Oh my goodness.
With the villager. So the nice. villager took out Ness. What the heck is
villager.
Going on?
Villager. Maverick.
Thought Ness was the best. What just happened, Vaughn?
It was supposed to be the best.
It was supposed to be the best.
Maverick got the win. So
it makes me sad.
Very sad.
It makes me corazón.
I just want to make a song or something. Play a song. But I can't bust out a guitar because there's none.
Okay, so now Villager won that first one.
So you got the second round. It's 1-0.
What does Ness have to do to come back?
He's got to use his bat. That's
the
right
way.
Time.
Okay.
You can't swing that bat around because that'll leave you wide open.
So that's what happened. The bat just was not utilized properly enough.
Yeah. You got to use it properly. And you don't forget the yo-yo. You got to have the yo-yo. And, yeah. So Ness has some street cred, so he's got to use that yo-yo.
Well, he wears his hat to the side. And
the side,
tells
yeah.
it all.
It's like Ash Ketchum. Okay.
Yeah. Oh. Ash Ketchum is not in this game, though.
Yeah, what?
He's not in this game, though, is he?
No, his counterpart was in the Brawl.
I see.
Red.
Oh, my.
So, but not in this game. Maybe on a DLC.
Oh, the DLC.
The lick.
Yes.
My goodness. There's a lot of guest celebrities and Ranger Stops. Ranger Stops.
Mostly,
Ranger
Stops. Yeah, mostly Ranger guests. There's going to be, we've got a couple video game voice acting guests, though, as
yes.
well. We got
very
Dan,
excited about that, by the way.
Yes, Dan Southworth, who is Virgil in Devil May Cry 3 and 4 and Marvel vs. Capcom 3. We got Ruben Langdon,
right.
who is the voice of Dante in Devil May Cry 3 and 4. Also in Marvel vs. Capcom 3. Yeah, he did the motion capture. He's done all the motion capture work for Chris Redfield. Since they started using motion capture, which was Code Veronica.
Yes. I think he was like the second person in the world or in history to be a motion capture actor. If that's what I understood. He's one of the first few people. That's what I know.
Probably in video games. Yeah.
In video games.
In video games. Yeah, I think so. But yeah, he's done a lot of motion capture work. Like he's done, voice of Ken Masters in Street Fighter.
Pictures. I mean,
he's been in a couple.
Yeah,
He's been in TV shows too. He's been in Japanese tokusatsu shows
right.
as a suit actor.
Right.
He was in B Fighter Kabuto.
As a monster,
yes,
for
as a suit actor.
Of you, yeah.
Well, he was also he played the role of Mac Windy. Mac Windy in B Fighter Kabuto, which here American audiences know that as Big Bad Beetleborgs Metallics.
Yes. Yes.
Metallics the second season.
Yes.
That's
Big Bad Beetleborgs and Metallics.
Yes. He was in that, so he's done a lot of stuff. He'll be there, so aside from Power Rangers guests, there's going to be some video game guests there as well. So people, y'all need
Johnny
to come out.
Johnny Bosch, by the way, who most of you would know as Adam, the Black Power Ranger,
yep.
the original Mighty Morphin Power Rangers.
Yes, he was also Ichigo in Bleach, as well as known for his role as Nero in Devil May Cry
right.
3.
Right.
Or is it 4? Was it 4?
4. It was 4.
4. I think it was 4,
yep,
right?
It was
yeah.
4. Yep.
Yeah. I was
Which
so
I
wrong.
I'm a big fan of Devil May Cry, so if you are, please stop by Ranger Stop.
Yes.
I said it twice, by the way.
Yes. Stop by there and get your smash. Get your smash,
smash on.
Is that appropriate to say?
I don't know.
I don't know if that's appropriate.
You just said it, but I'll
get your smash on. I don't know. That might not be appropriate for this. Let's say it again. Yeah, we're done. We're done with that one. Yes.
Done, son.
Yeah. Oh,
whoa.
There he goes flying.
Okay, so we're 1-1 stock.
Oh my.
Tribal at 40%.
This is pretty intense.
Underdog brackets, by the way, when they're underdogs. So yeah, this is a very close.
It's got to be the bat.
Yeah.
It's got to be the bat. He's got to use the bat.
Got to use the bat.
The bat's the only way.
Yo-yo. But you got the villager. You got the potted plant, the tree. Very dangerous weapons of destruction.
Mother Nature is aiding him.
Mother Nature's on the side.
Natural selection. Oh, the fire hydrant.
Oh.
It's a back and forth battle.
Yes, it is a back and forth battle.
Who's going to take it? Who's going to take it?
Who's going to take it?
Oh, my.
Only time can tell.
I understand none of this.
Yes. So, so Tribal has a chunk of damage on him. Ness.
All I could do is watch in pure
horror.
In a pure trance. I don't know. This is
very mesmerizing.
It is. The battle of these two children.
Yes, the battle of children.
The battle of the children street fighting.
The best, but I stand corrected.
Oh my gosh. What is it? What's gonna happen? Oh, headbutts. Did he fart? What was that? Did he fart?
Yeah, he farted. Yeah. Farted all right. That was exactly what he did.
Oh my.
Not
the fire hydrant. Is that a shovel? Oh, bowling ball. Yeah.
Stunned him a little bit though.
Oh, it didn't finish the job.
Oh my goodness. Someone's gonna win here in a minute. Or two. Or three.
It's gonna happen. Somebody's gonna do it, huh?
Yeah. Someone's gonna do it.
It's gonna happen. Oh. Who's it gonna be?
Who's gonna take this round? Getting close.
Which one of these children? Which one of these two kids is gonna come out? Oh, Lord. Lord have mercy. What's happening? He's gonna be with the fire hydrant. Oh, is it gonna be Ness? Oh, no. He's still alive.
He's still alive. Still
not picking up. Is he still alive? Still alive.
Oh, my goodness. This is a very close match.
Still alive. Oh, who's gonna do it? Who's gonna
close round.
Oh my gosh. This is
are we sweating here or is it just the temperature?
I don't know. This is I don't know what's going on here. I don't know who's gonna win. It's just one of these children. Well, they are technically the kids.
They're
characters. So
they're very young.
Oh my.
Oh,
so much violence. Whoa. The tree of woe.
Yeah.
It's the tree of all. Oh my! Oh! Oh! It's the fart for the win.
Winner this round. 1-1.
The fart for the win.
Yeah.
The power of flatulence has saved him this day.
The power of flatulence has prevailed.
Has prevailed and has advanced.
Oh my goodness.
This young man.
But
it has advanced tribal.
Yes, it has advanced tribal. Tribal still in this match. So we're going to move on to the third round, and that will decide who's going to win this match.
And I'm going to go get sushi, because I'm hungry. We got to get... Here we go.
All right, we're good.
Awesome. I'm going to go get sushi.
Okay, thank you very much, Jonathan. Again, check out his YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Toy Bounty Hunters, Ranger Stop.
Do it.
Get your tickets. Reserve it. Okay, so just me and the ghost. Never mind. Jovi.
Hi, I'm Manny.
Turns out to be the ghost. Oh, I mean Manny. Hey, Manny, how are you?
I'm fantastic.
Yeah, how was your day?
I went away and gained a couple pounds, but
yeah,
that's what.
Hey, Jovi.
I do not approve this message.
Hi, Jovi.
How are you doing? Shouldn't you be running the match right now?
Yeah, you should be. You should be.
You lazy bum.
Running. You should probably do that.
I'm just gonna stand here. I can run from here.
You can't run. You can't hide.
I'm not trying to hide.
You shouldn't. Should you be hiding? I feel like doing a stunner to you right now.
You should, yeah. Just Stone Cold Stunner.
What are you
RKO!
Selling? What are you buying?
So Maverick and Tribal have been at it.
Yeah.
Back in the last two rounds.
So first round goes to Maverick. Second round goes to Tribal. Who's going to win the third round?
Is he a Tribal Maverick?
A Tribal Maverick. I don't think so.
Run the Maverick Tribe.
So this is the eighth match?
Yeah. This is the eighth match. And so far it's been very interesting. These tiny little characters have been doing some amazing thing. Ness obviously with his psychic power and Villager with his whatever power.
I think
dreaded farming skills.
I think that the Villager has some form of the Beyonder's powers because he does things that defy physics and the laws of science.
Well, he also has a bag of holding, much like Kirby. Yeah. Instead of using his mouth, he just has a little sack that he just grabs stuff in and puts it there, and then whenever he needs it, he just throws it out.
Including a tree.
The tree just has... He might be a druid, because he makes things grow really quickly.
So you would say that his druid ability is maxed out at level 10?
I think it might be. He might be a cross class.
Really?
He probably is.
Like cross class or what?
I mean, he does have a slingshot, so that might be, you know.
Ranger. Or, no, Druid is still a
bowler, too.
A Druid does a use bowler. A slingshot.
He doesn't have a bowler hat. It's not gonna work.
He's not a baller. I'm sorry.
He's not a baller.
He's not balling.
He has an umbrella, so he's also part Mary Poppins.
So what is he?
He is a thing that does stuff.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah. There's a triangle for a nose. Oh, and apparently so does Ness at this point.
Fire jerk. Okay.
Listen. I need to ask you a question.
What is that question?
Only one.
Well, it's not a question. Somebody was saying that they're calling this the Big Head Battle or the Midget Battle.
The Midget Battle.
Yeah. The
I think that's...
Accurate?
That's offensive to Peter Dinklage.
We're not talking about Dinklage.
Okay.
We're talking about fictional characters here. Dinklage is real.
Wait. Oh, he's real?
Yeah, he's real.
Is he really?
Yeah.
Is he really real?
Yes, he's really real.
I thought he was CGI.
No, sir. He's just that good.
So you're saying we can go to his house... Stop.
Not anymore, not after this conversation.
Probably not. Hey, who goes there?
Okay, I don't see Peter Dinklage as the type of guy who would own a shotgun.
You never
Maybe
know.
A sniper.
Yeah, I could see that. I could see that. Or some type of hunting rifle.
Or a Glock.
Yeah.
Don't come any closer. It's like somewhere in the mountains.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wait.
Or a really awesome sword. Because, you know, he is a Lannister.
True.
Boom.
Boom.
Out goes Ness.
All right.
Villager at a huge percentage.
So I took a break. How many people were here? I saw John
just,
here.
It was just Vaughn.
Just me and Jonathan.
It was just Vaughn. That was
I saw Vaughn and John.
No, I don't know where you saw
it. Wait.
Yes, it was just me.
It was him.
Yep.
No!
Into the tribal, spirit realm.
Tribal trying to get even. Has a very Maverick with a very slighted percentage advantage.
Ever so slightly.
Ever so slightly.
I'm gonna.
At this point, I don't know. I don't even know who's gonna win this.
I'll be back.
You will be back. All right. So going back to the action, Ness is trying to shake off that percentage here.
Trying to
working out.
Got hit by a fire hydrant there.
Trying to bring back the same magic as he did in the last game. And
same psychic magic.
The same psychic magic. I mean, is there any other kind?
Any other what?
Any other kind other than psychic magic?
I don't know. I really don't know.
Well, they're the five magics. There are the five magics. Let's not talk about that. Oof. His alchemy is terrible. Friends don't let friends do alchemy.
Not with yellow alchemy.
No. Oh! This is... At any given times, Ness can just go away flying, but keep in mind that since They're the smaller characters, when they have a certain percentage, after 80%, they're ready to go out at any given time.
Anytime.
So, let's see. Oh, and he got it! He got it! Maverick takes the game.
Maverick takes.
That was a misinput, that statement. That was supposed to be a side.
Maverick takes the game.
Maverick says...
Are we getting an excuse for the win?
What?
He
sounds like an excuse.
Maverick pulls off the upset and eliminates Tribal.
Okay. What does that mean, Joe?
That means that Maverick is still in it and Tribal is out.
Out, son.
Maverick trying to ensure that he gets qualified for the Ranger Stop Invitational. All you can see is just smiles and I can see all his teeth. Look at all that.
Anyway,
we'll be back.
We'll be back.